In this introductory video, we'll pick up few general studies questions and try to clear the basics with regard to that particular question before we actually try to find the answer. We'll also just broadly look at the field of study with related to those questions and the brand new syllabus which's been released on the 5th of March 2013. It's not going to be about tips, advices or approaches, but basics with regard to that particular question. That means you may not have to really write all that, what I'm going to discuss in this video, for writing that answer. But the understanding you get is very important, not just for that answer, for many answers. I'm Pradeep and welcome to Learning Session. The question I have picked up is, as I've told you, it's a general studies paper 2. Of the 2012 paper. It's a 300 mark paper, and the questions I'm picking up is this. First question D. The human population is slated to grow to 9 billion by 2050. In this context, many scientists predict that plant genomics would play a critical role in keeping out hunger and preserving environment. Explain. That's the first question I'm going to discuss. Second one is second question D, which is, analyze critically the interlinkages between Convention of Biological Diversity and FAO Treaty, which is an international treaty on plant genetic resources for food and agriculture. So these are the questions I've picked up from the 300 mark paper of General Studies 2 of 2012 mains paper. Why have I taken up these two questions? It's very simple. Out of 300 mark paper, both these questions relate to food security and biotechnology. So of that broader field of study, we have two questions. The first one is a 25 mark question and the second one is a 15 mark question. Both together account for 40 marks, which is more than 13.3% of the entire question paper. So out of 300, you can get 40 if you understand it. These questions may not be repeated next time, but the field of study will remain the same, not just for these questions, but for many questions. The answer is just the final view you get from the top of a mountain. You'll not even know what it will be until you reach there. And how to reach there is the question. So let us look at the field of study and the syllabus and relate the terms to what we are looking at today, that is basics of biotechnology and food security. Let's look at the syllabus. Even though in the questions I've picked up, those two questions, there is no mention of the word biotechnology or food security. Rather, they mentioned genomics, genetic resources, tackling hunger and poverty. So that's quite understandable. Let's see what is food security. According to the FAO World Food Summit held in Rome in 1996, food security exists when all people at all time have physical and economic access to sufficient and nutritious food for their dietary needs, food preferences, for an active and healthy life. Now, food security depends on three pillars, or rather it stands on three pillars. One is availability, second is access, third is utilization or use. What is availability? You can translate it to food supply, whether the food is available in the regional, national or the international market. That is availability. Now, what is access? Access is physical and economic access. That is the food available so that I can access it? Then access whether I have a purchasing power to buy that food. Now, the third one is utilization or use. How do you use that food? Food and a critical aspect, it's not just food. You need water to use the food. You need water to cook. You need proper sanitation. The use is actually for nutritious food for a healthy life. So all these three pillars are very important. And these three pillars stand on the foundation, which is stability. Or if any of those pillars are not stable enough, your food security will not happen, or it will lead to food insecurity. So if there is a lack of availability, if there is no physical and economic access, and if there is no proper utilization, there will be food insecurity. So that's the basic understanding of food security which we need. Now the next topic is biotechnology. Just look at the term itself, bio and technology. What is a technology? All of us know a term related to that, that is techniques. All of us know what is a technique. Technology is, you know something, in simple terms you can say, you know something and you apply it for a practical use. It is a technology. So biotechnology, bio means life. So obviously combining something living, life, to technology. That is biotechnology. Let's look at the definition given by International Convention of Biological Diversity. And also it's the same definition which is given in the International Assessment of Agriculture Knowledge, Science and Technology for Development report, which is an important report which we'll be referring to when we talk about genetic modified organisms in the coming videos. So let's look at the definition of biotechnology. What is biotechnology? According to the definition, biotechnology is any technological application which uses biological systems, living organisms, to make or modify products or processes for a specific use. That's quite a broad definition of biotechnology which has been given. That's not the kind of perception we had about biotechnology in our mind, or the impression of the definition we had was something different. Because whenever we have heard of biotechnology, what comes into your minds is gene, genetics, genomics, gene splicing, tissue culture and all that. But this definition also includes all that also. But still, think about using biological systems and living organisms for making or modifying products or processes. What about cropping practices, which man has been doing for millennia together? Breeding and selection, which he was involved in for in the case of plants and animals, for crops, have been developed by humans also. Human intervention is a very important point for the development of the crops as we see now. So cropping practice has been happening for millennia together. Then fermentation technology, which is always in use. All this is also included under this broad-based definition. Tissue culture, gene splicing, and all that is also included in this definition. So we need to look at something more specific. What is that term? It is modern biotechnology. Now let's look at the definition of modern biotechnology given by International Convention. Modern biotechnology is defined as any biotechnological technique for manipulation of genetic material, fusion of cells beyond normal breeding barriers. So that point is important, beyond normal breeding barriers. So I hope that makes a difference between the earlier broad-based definition of biotechnology and this specific definition of modern biotechnology. So when you use the terms, I hope you'll be more confident in using the terms for the specific content where it is required. The term genomics is there, which is a bit kind of technical term. I know that may not be that useful for answering this question, but still understanding something gives us the greater trust or the greater confidence we need in approaching a question. So let's see what is genomics. All of us have learned in our school, we've heard about chromosomes, DNA and genes. But unfortunately, most of us are confused what are these. Now, let's look at that. Chromosomes are nuclear bodies. That is, they exist in the nucleus of cells and they actually carry the hereditary material, almost the entire hereditary material, other than things which happen in some organelles. DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA is ribonucleic acid. Macromolecules DNA, which are DNA, and proteins together make up the chromosome. And all of us are familiar with the DNA double helix structure. So a chromosome, you can say, is like this, and the DNA is this. And out of this, what is a gene? That's the question. According to simple definition you can give, in the double helix of DNA, there are certain segments which code for a particular protein. And that is a gene. Now, what is a genome? Genome consists of not just these genes, which are the coding part of DNA. It is also non-coding part. So the coding part and the non-coding part of DNA and RNA together, whether it's found in nucleus or elsewhere in organelles, together they form the genetic material, which is genome. And genomics is a study of the genome, its structure, function, and evolutionary significance. What is a genome? It's a complete set of genetic material. And what is genetic resource? Remember, that's the word which is used, plant genetic resources. Okay, the genetic resource is nothing but genetic material of current or future value. That is something which is used now or which has possible use in future. That is genetic resource. So this is just the beginning of the process of understanding these topics. Remember what I mentioned about questions and answers. Questions are mountains and answers are at the top. But nobody is going to ask you to climb the same mountain again and again. So let us learn the process of climbing. And that learning will help us tackle bigger, smaller, greater, lesser, similar, and different challenges and questions. Thank you.